Good evening, everyone. I'm Priya Sheth, and a very warm welcome to all of you to the Daily Dispatch. The startup world seems to be buzzing with activity midweek, and three companies that have been in news today include Car Dekho, MobiQuick, as well as Open. Well, headline number one, automobile platform Car Dekho has turned unicorn as it closes a $250 million round of funding. The funds will be used by the company to expand its used car as well as financial services businesses. Now, the startup is also working to expand its catalog to over 10,000 cars in the near future. Well, yet another unicorn fintech startup, MobiQuick, has entered the unicorn club as it prepares to go public. This development comes after the firm's recent secondary sale of shares held by employees under the ESOP plan, and the company is likely to list on the bourses ahead of Diwali at a valuation of $1.5 to $1.7 billion. And finally, neobanking platform Open has raised 735 crore rupees as part of its Series C funding round led by Temasek. There was participation from Google, SBI Investment, as well as existing investors such as Tiger Global, as well as 314 Capital. These funds will be used to boost its new product lines that are Switch as well as Banking Stack.
Special guest today on our segment is Tarun Sharma from mCaffeine’s. Thank you very much, Tarun, for joining us today on the Daily Dispatch. I want to begin by asking you about the last couple of months. You've seen a surge as far as personal care is concerned across the board. And I want to understand at mCaffeine’s, what has been your experience over the last couple of months, specifically as we enter the festive period at this point?
Thank you, Priya. Thank you for having mCaffeine’s me. In your show, obviously, it's not just about the last couple of months. I think the entire digital brands kind of saw great tailwinds from post-COVID period. But the last couple of months, I think being a digital-only brand in personal care space, we saw a tremendous amount of growth. I mean, the festive season had just started, and well, the marketplaces like Amazon, Flipkart are working well for us. But especially our own platform, mCaffeine.com, has been doing really amazing because of having a very high amount of customer love over the past 5 years. We could leverage that, and we were selling one unit per 2 seconds on our platform for the last 1 week. So the festive season has started great for us.
Right. You know, when you look at the kind of products that people are buying, what is the kind of categories that are doing well on the platform?
So for us, we are a personal care brand. We don't have any cosmetic line. So we operate in body care, face care, and hair care. Hair care is the newest entry for the brand. So it is very contextual to what we are as the brand. So for us, face and body are pretty much in equal proportion. But what is interesting is that we are market leaders in body scrub as a category, and we command more than 75% of the market share. So obviously that is a Shiro product for us and has kind of worked really, really well, obviously in the sale and pre-sale as well. But the newest launch, which we did in body care only, we launched a body wash in your favorite cup of coffee. And this cup of coffee is also infused with coffee grounds, and it's a patented product for us. That also did well. And we sold more than 100,000 units in just about a week. I didn't even have one unit to gift it to my wife. So that was the kind of demand which we saw for this product.
Right. You know, when you talk about the areas of focus going forward, what are you going to be focusing on? Are you introducing more categories at this point in time? If you could give us some perspective.
So mCaffeine has been around for around 5 years. We have operated digital only, and we have around 40 SKUs. This year, we could do close to about 200 odd crores in terms of sales. The idea is to reach to 700 odd crores in terms of the overall top line in the next 2-3 financial years. And to do that, we'll obviously enter into more categories. We are at this point of time, hair care is very nascent for us. Face, we have only 3-4 categories which are prominent for us. So we'll continue to launch products, but at the same time, being a very sticky brand, we would want to have revenue by product density as the highest as ever for the brand. And at this point of time, we have 3 times better revenue by product density as compared to the market, and we'll continue to make it better. So product launches will happen, but at the same time, we are expanding our digital distribution. We have been really active on Amazon and Nykaa, but now we are working very closely with Flipkarts of the world to kind of make sure that our horizontal distribution and online increases. But at the same time, we are going deeper in our existing channels. Outside online, we have started our offline efforts. In just about 45 days, we have been present in more than 1,000 point of sales touch points. The idea is then in the next 15 months, we should be at close to about 10,000 odd stores, and mCaffeine should take a relevant shelf space in these 10,000 stores. Outside online and offline, we are also launching our international geographies. We have received tremendous amount of demand, and you know, caffeine, you don't have to explain coffee across the globe or caffeine across the globe. So that is something which we have as a brand, as a head start. So we are launching 3 countries this quarter, and the idea will be in the next 15 months, we should be close to about 20 odd countries as an expansion for us.
Right. You know, when you look at the kind of aggressive expansion that you've planned, are you also looking at some sort of fundraise at this point? Because you have targets for 700 crore in revenue and expansion as well to other countries. So what kind of investment are you going to be pumping in?
So we raised some capital last year. Amicus Capital led the round. It's a private equity fund based out of Bangalore. So we are decently capitalized. We have always been profitable as a brand. We have made our CM2s are very high with respect to our unit economics. So we are decently capitalized at this point of time. We have received inbound interest from relevant funds in the market. And beauty personal care is also is one of the categories from a digital standpoint. So we're getting inbound interest and the right amount of capital which is required to grow this business.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, Tarun, for joining us. Dispatch, it's been a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Priya. Thank you so much.
Well, on that note, many thanks for tuning in to today's Daily Dispatch. I'll catch you tomorrow at 5 p.m. Goodbye and see you soon.